All right, y'all, in this video, I'm going to show you how to make instrumental beats similar to the Money Trees song by Kendrick Lamar. All right, make sure you start in live loops, all right? Not tracks, so live loops, and then hit new. All right. So first thing I'm going to queue up, get the song queued up here, the instrumental, all right? And play here. I'm going to start with this first part, all right? Hone in on the drum part, all right? It's a hi-hat. All right, so I'm going to recreate that part first. All right, so get this out of here. I'm going to hit plus instruments and go to my beat sequencer. All right, here under the drums. So that first part is just the hi-hats. Just repeat it over and over. Oh, almost forgot. I got to change the tempo setting. All right, so setting. Tempo, I know Money Trees is at 72 beats per minute. All right, you can Google any song, beats per minute, and find out how many beats per minute it is. So put that at 72. All right. Now, it sounds a lot more like it. So hi-hats just repeated there over and over. Now it's got an open hi-hat right there at the on the first beat. All right. And that's pretty much it for that first part. I'm gonna hit record. Just let that record out. All right, there's our first drum track. We got the hi-hats going. All right, so I'm gonna go back to my grid here. All right, hit play there, just verify that sounds like that, all right. All right, now let's listen to the synth part playing in the background. That's the part we're gonna do next. Now, I will say this, there's not a synth sound that sounds exactly like that in GarageBand, but we can get kind of close to that, all right? So, go back over here, we're gonna hit plus, go to instruments again. All right, then we're gonna go to Alchemy Synth. All right, I'm gonna hit the smart piano there. Then we gotta edit these chords to be the chords that are in Money Trees, all right? So Money Trees, it starts with E minor, but then the second chord is F sharp minor. All right, followed by G major seven. So G major seven. All right, and then C major seven. And then finally, B minor. So that last one's gonna be B minor. All right, all set with the chords, all right? So I can just tap through them just to verify. All right, they do sound real similar to the chords used. The sound that I found to be fairly closest to it was the classic simple pad. All right, so that's the one I'm gonna use to record the beats now. All right, now I got to record it. I'm just going to tap edit on it real quick just to make sure all my notes are right on beat. All right, you'll see here some of the notes are a little off, so I'm going to just select them, slide them right on beat to that light gray line. And these are just barely off, but I'm just going to go ahead and fix them here real quick. All right, now I got that done. Let's click done. I'm gonna add some sound effects onto that synth track. All right, so I'm gonna click on the synth. Have my EQ up there. I'm gonna turn the reverb up here. All right. I'm also gonna go into plugins and EQ. I'm gonna add some chorus onto it. So hit edit, input chorus. Just gonna tweak this a little bit. Good good practice when adding effects is to go all the way up or all the way down and then slightly go back until you like how it sounds, all right? I'm gonna also add a little flanger onto it. I don't need a lot, so I'm gonna decrease the mix. All right, sounds good. So next step, we're gonna add in the second synth. So if we take a listen to what I have so far. Okay, we got our synth hi-hats going. Now, if we listen to the track again, you'll hear in the background, you have the synth playing, but there's also like a vocal sample kind of being played softly in the background that matches the same chords as the synth. And you kind of hear the voices kind of singing like they're in the background. So we're gonna try to find something similar here in GarageBand. We're gonna use the sampler, all right? So I'm gonna hit that plus there, instruments. This time I'm gonna use the sampler, all right? Within the sampler, you can import different sounds and use it just like the smart piano. All right, I gotta quickly change over my chords to the same chords used. Now GarageBand does have some sounds that we can import here that are similar to the vocals, all right? If you go into your Apple Loops vocal section, all right, that's where we have some vocal samples that we can see if we can get something that sounds similar. Now, I've downloaded a bunch, save some time. This one, the Break Free Choir Pad, my opinion is one that sounds closest to what's being used, all right? So click on that, download it. Now it is a reverse loop, so I'm going to click that reverse up button up there on the sample and just kind of turn it back into the normal voice sample, all right? So in through messing around, pressing the different chords, I found out that the E minor, F sharp minor, and then one up on F sharp minor sound the most similar to those vocals in the background of the Money Trees track. I'm just going to make this two bars because it just repeats that over and over. All right, I notice it just repeats that E minor, F sharp minor for those vocals. I don't have to make it four bars like the synth one, so we'll just keep it at two bars. All right, so now I have my drum pattern and the synths used at the beginning of the song. I'm gonna add a little more sound effects onto this one. Cut the treble down a little bit. Put some reverb on. Put a little chorus on there. And I'm actually gonna do some double reverb. I'm gonna put some track reverb on. The dry and wet. Dry is the original sound. Wet is the amount of reverb you're putting on. So, all right, take a quick listen to that. All right, now it doesn't sound exactly like Money Trees, but it sounds pretty close to it. All right, so now we're gonna listen to the some more of the song so we can hear what other instruments come in after this point. All right, so I'm gonna hit play on our song. So you'll notice here after this first part that a clap comes in as well as an 808 sub bass or used kind of like a kick drum. Now you want to pay attention to the pattern and when it repeats. So listen closely here. This pattern, this drum pattern goes for four bars, all right? So we need to make this next drum pattern four bars. It's got that double clap there at the end of the four bars. All right, so we're gonna come back over here, go to our beat sequencer. Right, we need to make this drum length four bars. So I'm gonna click on the 64 steps. All right, that gives us the four sections there at the top you see, all right. Now we're gonna put in our clap. Clap goes on beats two and four. All right, so I'm gonna start drawing them in here so you can kind of hear it. All right, tap to the next section, beats two and four, beats two and four. Now this last one, we got beats two, and then a double clap right here. All right, I took some experimenting to figure out where that double clap goes, so don't get discouraged if you can't figure it out right away. Just take some practice. All right, now we're gonna record this and add it into our live loops. All right, there's our drum loops. Now I'm gonna copy and paste our synth loops over just to create another column here. All right, because now we're gonna add our 808 in. All right, so I'm gonna play those three. All right, we got our clap going. Now our 808 in this song kind of acts like the kick drum. All right, so we're gonna go into Alchemy Synth. All right, and then put it on the smart piano. And the chords that we need are already there. Now the 808 I found sounds real similar to the song is the Super Sub 808. So I'm gonna click on that. Not the solid, sorry, the Super Sub 808. Alright, now the Sub 808 uses the same chords or same notes as we did for our synth. So E minor, F sharp minor, G, C, B. So they got it recorded. Play it here just so you can hear it. And that bass is pretty low. I'm gonna show you here in a second how we can make that kind of stand out a little more. All right, I know some of my notes are a little off, so I'm just gonna edit those real quick and get them on beat. If you zoom in here, you can see how some of these are a little off. So I'm just gonna slide them over, get them snapped into a grid. All right, just take some trial and error. What you don't see is the multiple times I listened back and forth, recording this multiple times to match up to the exact kick beat that's used in Money Trees, all right? So this does take some practice trying to match up exactly to what you're trying to recreate. But once you kind of know the rhythm, through trial and error and sliding these different notes, snapping them into the grid, you kind of understand where they're going to go. All right, so there I got my 808. All right, so now I got the main part of the beat now. All right, we got our synths, the hi-hats and clap, and now the 808, which also is acting as a similar to a kick drum in this song. All right, again, now I'm ready to record the song. So the song starts off with that first column, plays it for a couple loops, then it goes to the second column. And honestly, Money Tree is pretty simple beat. It just goes back and forth between those two columns to create the full song. So I'll just record the first part here. I'm not gonna record a full 4 minutes for Money Trees. I'm gonna show you here in a second how I want that 808 to stand out a little more. So once we're done recording, I'm gonna give you one quick tip how to do that with your 808s. All right, stop it there. All right, so again, I'm gonna click the 808. I just want it to stand out a little more. Hit plugins and EQ. So the compressor is one tool you have to kind of make your kicks or sub 808 stand out a little more. I'm gonna bring the threshold up a little bit. Now the ratio is what gives you some thump to that. I'm gonna put it up to about 6. And honestly, you can just tweak with the attack. Just listen to it here, the different sound, the different effects it does as you go from one extreme to the other, and then kind of put it in the area you want. Now, once I did that, the 808 started peaking out in red there at its level, so we got to bring the gain down just a little bit, just so that it doesn't peak out there. All right, that's how we add a little more thump to our 808. All right, now we can see the track view. All right, that first intro part, and then it goes into the main beat for the verse. Alright, so there's our Money Trees beat, similar to Money Trees, I say, made in GarageBand. Alright, thanks for watching. See you next time.